Did you think Robin, the Bird and the Brain, the fan-made short film web series part 1 of 3 was perfect? It just doesn't work. Just cut to the intro sequence. This thing doesn't open. Fuck. Yep. Fuck. Welcome back to another episode of Movie Maintenance. Today we have a very special episode on our hands. Why is it special, you may ask? Well, because typically in Movie Maintenance we deal with like big picture, like big blockbuster. But this time we're working with a smaller fan-made short film. Now on a typical episode of Movie Maintenance we analyze, oh, maybe the writing was an issue. Maybe it was the structure of the story, or maybe this character's motivation didn't make sense. There's typically a big thing that kind of messes up a film that needs fixing. But today in this episode, it's not like that at all. It's just a bunch of tiny little details that we're going to comb through in chronological order from the start to the end. If you guys haven't seen Robin, the Bird and the Brain, it's fantastic. It's linked down below, so you guys can go watch that if you haven't seen it already and come back and watch this video. That being said, let's just go ahead and start from the very beginning. Oh, sorry. I already have to stop it. There's a little bit of an awkward edit right here where the visual comes in first and then a second later the audio of the downbeat of this song comes in. Here, let me slow it down to show you. We have the visual, then the downbeat. It's a little bit of an awkward timing there. So we can go ahead and do a quick little edit to clean that up. Here. See, now that's a lot cleaner. So before, instead of having a visual cue and then an audio cue, we can utilize the downbeat of the song as a splashing in point for our story and where it begins. Okay, now we have that squared away, let's go ahead and move on. Okay, I'm gonna have to stop it again right here. There's a shadow of the camera and the cameraman on our actor's face. So in order to make this fix, this one will be a little bit more hypothetical. Here, I'll draw it out for you. Okay, so the way I can communicate this to you is just through stick figures. I'm not the best illustrator, but I'll do my best. So we have our character Robin. Then we have our camera and our cameraman. Then behind him, we have the light source. And then this is the eye line of the camera as our character and camera does this swooping motion. Our light source is obviously coming from behind. The way the camera is situated here is directly in between the light and our actor. So what we could do to make a change is place the camera down lower to the ground, maybe by a foot, have our cameraman in the twerking position, and then from there we would angle the camera upwards towards our actor, and that would leave the light going directly to his face, as opposed to our cameraman's head. All right, we're gonna go ahead and jump a couple minutes forward to the scene with Harley Quinn where this happens.
I'm gonna be teaching you how to bake these delicious cookies, and we're gonna be doing some arts and crafts and, oh God. Zach, you've gotta believe me, come on, please. He hasn't been here for like 4 days, I don't know where he is. Come on, I don't know anything, I swear. Come on, please, don't hurt me, please.
I think this scene was a little bit jarring for me just because the size of Batman's shadow is just a little bit overblown. It kind of made me think of this meme. From here we could jump about 22 seconds to a general shot of pedestrians. And in this shot we have another shadow present. This could be fixed by doing the technique I mentioned before, or just moving the camera in a different spot.
Stay warm, and make sure to leave some cookies out for the man in red.
In this shot we have the voiceover of the radio host saying, "Make sure you leave cookies out for the man in red." That was obviously written to be a play on Santa Claus being red and also Robin being red. But what we're being shown is just a black cape as opposed to some of his red shirt. So what they could have done is have his cape a little bit offset of his shoulders so we could see the back of his red shirt. So once we get that message, we could actually see something in red.
Family must have packed up the Christmas tree and left.
That was kind of an awkward edit with the door just slamming right there. I think it was intended to visualize the family packing up and leaving, but it just doesn't visually translate well. They could have just left that edit out because it just adds nothing to the scene. And then after that, we have a little bit of awkward dialogue between Robin and Oracle.
Three letters. Two other victims with 10 letters in total. Please think it's some kind of puzzle.
It's not.
It's not.
Thanks, Robin. She literally just said that.
It's not.
It's not.
I'm not sure if it was the writing that made that a little awkward or if it was the delivery.
D-A-B, C-B-H, E-C-I-E. It's a phone number.
If you had that information the whole time, then why would you go to the crime scene? You already had the pieces of the puzzle, so there was no real reason to go there.
Batman hasn't come out of the bathroom in about 6 hours.
You didn't even look at your watch! Alright guys, it's at this point in the video I would like to get a little disclaimer out, okay? I know you guys are probably thinking, what do you think, you're Mr. Hot Shit? Like your shit don't stink? So you're just perfect and it gives you a right to just shit on other people's work? What have you done, huh? What have you done? No, I don't think that at all. I make so many mistakes. I directed a music video for a band that I work with, and in a couple of the shots, there was only supposed to be two people in the frame, and in the background, you would see one of our crew just standing there watching. And I didn't even realize when I was recording a couple of the takes.
I'm a fucking idiot.
Idiot!
Trust me, I've fucked up a ton, and I continue to fuck up. There's probably 10 mistakes in this video right now. What they have done is incredible. With little to no budget and a couple of friends, they made something incredible, and it's honestly truly inspiring. It's inspiring to see other people as passionate about film as I am, and also as passionate about DC characters as I am. But just because it's incredible and it's inspiring doesn't make it free from constructive criticism. In the future, I do plan on doing a movie maintenance or a music video maintenance on my own music video. And when I do that, trust me, I'm gonna rip myself a new asshole. I just want you guys to understand, I don't think I'm all that. I'm just passionate about this stuff. So going from there, let's just continue on with the video.
Where do all these freaks come from?
Once again, with the awkward delivery.
There you go, bitch. Hey,
hey, hey.
It's the Joker's town here.
Get off of me!
If this is an attempted mugging or rape, why did we hear the sound of an explosion? We weren't shown any explosion. So maybe we could have the audio cue be her screaming and Robin would hear her and then go and save her, as opposed to an explosion with no explosion shown.
Hey! Let her go.
Why cut into a close-up when you just had that beautiful whip pan? You have one of the cleanest whip pans I've seen, and then you cut to a close-up shot of him delivering the line. Why not just deliver the line right after you whip the camera to him? I think it would have looked better like this.
Hey! Let her go.
Yeah, what the fuck is Tommy Hilfiger doing over here? We get it, dude. You have abs. Making the rest of us feel bad about ourselves. Shit. Once again, we have another shadow of the cameraman being shown. There's a bit of a linger on the shot with the Joker henchman pointing the gun at Robin. The amount of time he was given there to pull the trigger was more than enough. I understand they pulled off a cool camera movement and showing that off is really cool, and also keeping long takes within action is amazing, but we have to keep in mind the logistics of a fight scene. If you're in the middle of a fight and someone pulls a gun on you, they're not going to give you that much time. So in reality, the story could have ended there with the Joker henchman just pulling the trigger and killing Robin. So to make it a little bit more believable, we could tighten up that edit just a little bit. Yo, what the fuck is homeboy over here doing? What is he just on spectating mode? I guess this is kind of better than just falling down randomly without being hit. Also, this kind of opens up a visual plot hole. Robin just kicked the gun out of that guy's hands, and now his friend is just standing there instead of grabbing the gun. So maybe what they could have done is had the gun get kicked under the car so no one would be able to get it. Here comes Santa Claus, here comes Santa Claus, right down Santa Claus Lane. He doesn't care if you're rich or poor, he loves you just the same. Santa Claus knows we're all God's children, that makes everything right. So fill your hearts with Christmas cheer, cause Santa Claus comes tonight. Here comes Santa Claus, here comes Santa Claus, right down Santa Claus Lane. He'll come around when chimes ring out that it's Christmas morn again. Peace on earth will come to all if we just follow the light. So let's give thanks to the Lord above, cause Santa Claus comes tonight.
There's an abandoned hospital on 5th and Spring. I'm sending you the location now.
Thanks, Orson.
Be careful.
Robin's kind of a dick. I'm cool with him stealing cars. I'm even cool with him kicking down this door when he could have just went around. But hanging up on a bitch? That's where I draw the line.
Let's go! What are you doing? You're safe now. You're safe.
To tell you something. Ben.
I'm sorry, but I call bullshit. Robin would never just put his hands up with a gun in his face. You're telling me that someone that was trained by Batman would just put his hands up? No. Robin would have been like, brah, 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 brah. I mean, he wouldn't have had to, like, break her wrist or nothing, but just, like, twist her wrist or something? That kind of really took me out of the moment because it was very uncharacteristic of Robin. I see them blue. For me and you, and I think to myself, Merry Christmas. What a wonderful world. Yeah, this is kind of another visual plot hole with the question mark being on his head. Like, wouldn't you think someone would notice him over here on the phone exclaiming all these things that he was saying to Robin and then connect the dots that there's a question mark killer going around the city killing people and they see the dude with the question mark on his head? Wouldn't they be like, hey, Mr. Policeman, that's the dude. Like, why even have the question mark? You could have just had the green hat, and that would have obviously told the audience, hey, this is the dude. Because we know who the Riddler is. We know about the question mark. We know he likes green. And that's pretty much it for my criticisms. Other than those, this was a pretty solid project. This was really impressive to see. Especially with little to no budget, it's shot really well. But I can't help the feeling that it's missing a little something. Hold on. Hello, Alex? Hey, what's up, man? Yeah, I just have a couple questions. Would you mind if we hopped on Skype real quick? I kind of just want to audition for a little part in the next, in Robin 2. So, yeah? All right, cool. I'll see you on in a couple minutes. Thanks, man. See ya. Oh, hey, guys.
Hey, man. It's Alex from HiTop Films. Thanks for calling. My lady friend Natalie's going to walk in the frame in a few seconds.
Thanks for giving me a chance to, you know, audition. I think that I would make a great addition to the team. I'm very versatile.
Yeah, man, we dig your content. Just show us what you got.
Yeah, we'd love to see you can bring to the table.
Yeah, just show us.
Yeah, I'll start it right now. Let me, just give me 1 second.
Okay, man.
Whenever you're ready.
Yeah, take your time.
I'm Batman. You're trying out for Batman.
I was kind of envisioning, like, Batman with longer hair. You know, like, more like a Tommy Wiseau type enhancement to it. You know what I mean?
Are you sure you don't want to go with, like...
You're called Armored Penguin,
so you can be, like, Penguin.
Penguin.
Or, like...
Batman.
Somebody else.
Yeah, Batman doesn't really look like that.
Yeah, I think...
That's not our vision.
I don't know about the long hair with the...
Yeah. Mask is kind of shitty.
Yeah, a little bit.
I got the moves. I got the moves for Batman, too. Like... Oh, shit. You know what I'm saying? Batman would wear, like, gym shorts, you know what I mean? Like, he would always be rocking gym shorts. Why wouldn't he be, you know?
Yeah, you know, we're thinking more of, like, a, you know, more like a Ben Affleck-type looking guy.
Yeah, we want kind of a, like, a somber kind of vibe. There's, I don't, like, know about the...
Yeah.
The gym shorts are a little bit...
It's a little...
Just yeah. A little bit not what we're thinking of.
Sorry, dude.
You guys want to hear, like, some dialogue? Where's Rachel?
Yeah, are we gonna bring it to him that he kind of doesn't have
He sucks.
Yeah. Yeah, I know. Just let him go. I don't know how to hang up on him.
You know, I have like other versions of Batman that I could do. You know, hold on, give me a second.
Can we just...
Yeah, no.
Should we just wait?
Yeah, I think...
All their auditions in the movie.
No, I don't even know if I want Batman in the movie. Let's just wait.
Yeah, hey, Robbie, can you bring me some Wendy's home? Yeah, like an extra large fry. Cool. Thanks, man.
Right? Because, like, Batman is, like, typically known for being fit, right? But you got all these beautiful people in your movie. Robin's beautiful. Oracle's voice is beautiful. Harley Quinn is beautiful. Even the douchebag that lifts up his shirt is beautiful. Like, every single person, beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. But you guys need a little diversity. You guys need a little bit of more ugliness, you know?
Thanks, you know, like,
yeah,
thanks for
we appreciate
calling
it.
The
I mean,
crew beautiful, but
we see where you're coming from.
You know, like, everyone in comic books, except you're trying out for Batman, and Batman's
like, you kind of gotta nail it. Like,
Bruce
there's
Wayne
really,
gets girls, man.
You can't, there's no, like, diversifying that character,
Bruce
you
Wayne
know what I mean?
Gets,
like, you just gotta...
So that's what I was thinking, like, bringing, like, a fat Batman, like, you know, he's lazy, he's unemployed, you know, bringing him to the big screen, I think that'd be, like... Trend, like, very important and groundbreaking, you know? What do you think? What do you guys think?
I don't know if you have the look.
It's just something that we're just skeptical about the whole situation because Batman is such a classic character.
We don't really want to change him up.
We want to, like, keep everything sort of...
Okay, I mean, I could do, like, another character if you guys want. I got characters on deck. Hold on.
Should we go? Should we just hang up the phone?
Skype.
I don't know.
Like,
yeah, there's
like,
no...
It's really rude.
Yeah, I don't...
We don't want to get a bad rap.
Oh, fuck.
Can he hear us?
I don't know. I think he's...
I'm pretty sure we're muted. He's just doing his thing.
I think he's coming back to the camera. I can't
tell. Is he talking to us again?
I don't know. Let's just...
I guess we just wait it out.
I guess so, yeah.
Oh, I'm a little woozy.
Dude, are you good?
Like, did he just peel over?
Did he pass out?
Was that all the exercise that he got in today? Is that? Was that?
Do we like call? Should we call an ambulance?
Did he have a heart attack?
Man, are you good?
Yo,
dude.
Armored Penguin Joey, are you?
Dude,
are you
good? Are you okay?
I'm good, guys. I'm good. I'm good. So, what'd you guys think?
Yeah, man, I'm just gonna be honest here. She wants to be nice about it, but, like...
We don't see a future for you. I'm sorry.
To be honest,
you gotta find a different career. Like, engineering might be good for you.
Excuse my,
like,
language. Bleep me out if you want, but that was fucking terrible.
Yeah,
you
you're really
never,
bad.
Ever
you're
act
really,
again.
You don't have it, like...
We make... we're making a fan film, and we're telling you you don't have it. I'm not expecting some DiCaprio-level acting, but you're worse than, like, a CW actor. That's even mean to CW actors. You're worse than, like, I don't even know. You're, like...
You're just really bad, man. You just, like, you need to consider other options. Like, yeah. We don't want to, like...
Damn. It was that bad, huh? I mean, I've been practicing, I've been rehearsing, I've been like hitting the gym, I've been hitting the Big Macs. Stop texting me!
We're always looking for more PAs.
Yeah, like, yeah. We need a sound guy right now.
Yeah, so.
You can handle the boom.
Yeah,
like,
but your acting is just fucking.
It's just really bad. It's truly awful. Some of the worst I've seen.
Oh,
honestly.
God, it's just.
Like, you make me want to cry.
I get it. You guys got a good thing going on. I don't want to intrude. I don't want to come over there and steal the show and everybody be like, oh, who's that guy? You know, I understand. I'll just talk to you guys later. Thanks for your help, and I appreciate your time. Why am I pointing? I don't know. I'll see you guys later.
We are still here.
Yeah.
You're still on a call with us, man.
You're just being so unprofessional right now.
This is really embarrassing for you.
This is...
I'm, like, super embarrassed for you right now. Man. You gotta hang up the phone before you have a reaction like that, man.
Yeah. Just next time, you know. Don't...
Way to make it weird.
Next time you
think
about...
Way to make it weird.
Next time you think about acting, don't...
Oh. I'm still on Skype. Here, let me hang up. Hold on. Bye, guys.
Do that again.
Why?
I want to get further out.
Oh, so you can see me in the car?
You can see you in the car, but your feet were cut off.
Well, if you can't see my feet, you can't see the car.
You can see the car, but you can't see your feet.
That makes no fucking sense.
Bitch, look at the video.
Bruce
Wayne, you know what I mean?
Gets,
like, you just gotta...
You get some of that poo tag. I don't know if that's...
Ready?
Yeah.
All I'm doing is looking at a toy car. I can't do it. Alright, ready?
Why can't you do it?
Ready?
Yeah.
I can't do it. This is the hardest thing I've ever done. Okay, alright, ready? There's a rock right here.
Oh! Don't do that to me.
What?
I look down and you're like, have this like stupid looks, like happy kid playing with a toy, you're like...